Hello students, I am Gnaneshwara TN, Assistant Professor of English. In the previous session, we had discussed key points of the speech Voluntary Poverty delivered by Mahatma Gandhi. In this session, we shall discuss some of the themes in the speech. Simplicity is the hallmark of Gandhi's life and so is his language. His transparent sincerity makes both the man and his writings plain, simple, and straight. His ideas are simple as his language, but the impact of his ideas is great. His simple, plain, idiomatic English reminds one of the Bible. His sentences are generally short and aphoristic, when long, loosely coordinated. It is the style of the public speaker and orator, full of repetition but not artificially rhetorical. He never cared for what may be called the graces of style, and that is perhaps one reason why his writings have great power. He thought like the wise and spoke like the common man. We shall discuss some of the themes in the speech. Voluntary poverty means to embrace poverty willingly, to live like a poor man even though it is not inevitable, to lead a simple life, to abandon the things which are considered as a luxury, in other words, a willing surrender. When Gandhiji was drawn into the political coil, he wished to remain absolutely untouched by immorality, untruth, and political gain. It was a difficult struggle in the beginning, and it was a wrestle with his wife and children. Gandhiji came to the conclusion that if he had to serve the people, he must discard all his wealth, all his possession. In the beginning, the progress was slow and it was painful for him, but as days went by, it became a matter of positive joy to give up things which he used to consider as his. Then the things slipped away from him very quickly. He experienced a great burden fell off his shoulders, and he felt that he could walk with ease and serve his fellow men with great comfort. He tells that when you dispossess yourself of everything you have, you really possess all the treasures of the world. He tells that when you dispossess yourself of everything you have, you really possess all the treasures of the world. Gandhiji found that if he kept anything as his own, he had to defend it against the whole world. He found also that there were many people who did not have the thing although they wanted it. He said to himself, if they want it and would take, they do so not from any malicious motive, but they would do it because theirs was a greater need than his. He thought that possession was a crime. He could only possess certain things when he found that others who also wanted to possess similar things are able to do so. Gandhiji observes that the basis of culture or civilization is understood to be the multiplication of all our wants. If you have one room, you will desire to have two rooms, three rooms, the more the merrier. And similarly, we will want to have as much furniture as we can put in our house and so on. And the more we possess, the better culture we represent. But in his opinion, the less we possess, the less we want, the better we are. Gandhiji suggests us to dedicate our body, soul, and mind for the service of our fellow beings. He says that even the body is not ours. It has been given to us as a temporary possession, and it can also be taken from us by God who has given it to us. So he says that this body must be used not for pleasure but merely for service. Gandhiji warns the audience of understanding the meaning of the thing superficially. Want must not be taken literally. He suggests to understand the spirit behind it. He is aware that to reach absolute perfection is an impossibility. Gandhiji tells that he has heard from very many Christian lips that they guard their food in answer to prayer. He says that if food is necessary, food will come to you. Gandhiji tells that God is the hardest taskmaster. He tests us completely. When your faith is failing and you are sinking, he comes to your assistance somehow or other and proves to you that you must not lose your faith and that he is always at your beck and call on his terms, not on your terms. Dear students, let us recall what we have learnt in this session. Simplicity is the hallmark of Gandhi's life and so is his language. He never cared for what may be called the graces of style, and that is perhaps one reason why his writings have great power. Themes in this speech are voluntary poverty, politics, non-possession, difficulty of possession, civilization, service, practicality, power of prayer, and faith. Thank you for watching the video till the end. Have a nice day.